In this video, we are going to discuss about LTI systems and its convolution. So we already discussed about LTI systems, that LTI is nothing but linear time invariant system, in which if a system is said to be LTI system, it need to obey both linearity and superposition, and here time invariance. So a system is said to be LTI system means it's going to obey both linearity, system linearity, and time invariance. Then that is said to be linear time invariant system. So here we are going to use convolution concept in LTI system to provide the response of particular LTI system. That means if you want to consider the system impulse response and input relation to get output, you need convolution. That means, for example, if you are having any LTI system, you are having any excitation or input, and you are having any output or response. So here I am considering that output or response as y of t and input as x of t, and your system, LTI system, is having some impulse response h of t. Then if you want the relation between output and input and impulse response of the system, then you require convolution. So before getting into the equations for output, so we are going to discuss about convolution here. Convolution is nothing but a mathematical operation which express input-output relation of a LTI system. Convolution is nothing but a mathematical equation or operation, so which is going to provide the relation of input-output and impulse response of a LTI system. Coming to convolution, convolution is widely used in many sectors and many fields like probability and statistics, and here convolution of two signals always produces a third signal. That means it's going to produce a different signals. So here, by using convolution, we can find the zero state response of a system. So many times in any technical exam, they will ask what is the zero state response of the system. Then that zero state response of a system can be found by using convolution of the system. So here, if you saw, this is continuous system, continuous convolution. So whenever you are having x of n, so x of n and h of n and y of n as your input of system and impulse response of the system and output of system, that convolution is called as discrete convolution. That means if you want the relation of your system output, input, and your impulse response in discrete domain, then you need to consider your discrete convolution. If you need your output, input, and impulse response relation in continuous domain, then you need to use your continuous convolution. Now I will give you the equations for continuous convolution and discrete convolution. Now here the output of LTI can be noted as y of t is equivalent to x of t convolution with h of t. Like this we can represent the convolution. This is the symbol for convolution. Star is the symbol for convolution. And here always the LTI system output is equivalent to input convolution with impulse response. Then what is the meaning of this star? What is the meaning of this convolution? If you return x of t star h of t, then this is equivalent to integral minus infinity to infinity. So x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. So here by observing this equation itself, we can say convolution is nothing but sliding one signal over reflected and folded and shifted signal. This is actually, for example, this t, if I consider like tau, so if I consider like tau, here if minus tau, if you are having in impulse response, that means that is a folded signal. Actually shifted means, so for example here, so tau I am considering like my time period, present time period, and here for that time period my signal x of t slides over this signal. This signal is a shifted impulse signal. That means so h of tau minus t will be its shifted impulse response, and it will become folded signal when you are giving so t minus tau. So when you are giving reversal, time reversal, then that is called as folded and shifted signal. So by observing this equation itself, we can say convolution is the process of sliding one signal over folded and shifted version of other signal. So this is folded and shifted version of impulse response, and here is your input signal. So sliding of input signal over folded and shifted version of impulse response will provide you convolution of those two. So that is nothing but y of t. So here in the same way you can write this same equation. So that means you can keep your impulse response as it is, and you can fold and shift your signal x of t. That means like this also you can write. So h of tau x of t minus tau d tau also you can write as x of t convolution with h of t. Like this or like this you can do, you are going to get same thing. So that means this is about continuous convolution. Coming to discrete convolution, if you are going with discrete convolution, that means you need discrete response of a system for a discrete input and discrete impulse response, then that x of n is equivalent to, y of n is equivalent to output or response of a system, y of n is equivalent to x of n convolution with h of n. Now similar to here, I am going to represent with the equation for this term. That means what is the discrete convolution equation? Here whatever integration is there, that I am going to convert into summation as we are in discrete mode. So summation k is equivalent to minus infinity to infinity. So x of n h of n minus k is the discrete convolution value. So similarly we can shift x of n and we can put it as it is as h of n. So that means we can write like this also, k is equivalent to minus infinity to infinity h of n x of n minus k. So like this also we can write. So this is continuous convolution. Here this is discrete convolution. Mostly we are going to use continuous convolution in problems. Definitely you are going to get problems on continuous convolution. 90% of the problems will come from continuous convolution, but discrete convolution also very important. So here whatever we are having as output of LTI system, that can be described by convolution only. The equation for convolution is always like this: integral minus infinity to infinity x of tau h of t minus tau d tau, or integral minus infinity to infinity, you just keep this impulse response as it is and fold and shift your signal, then you are going to get same continuous convolution formula. So here in place of integration, if you substituted summation, then you will get a discrete formula, and you need to replace that t with n. So y of n is equivalent to always the discrete convolution is equivalent to summation k equivalent to minus infinity to infinity x of n h of n minus k, or you can use this formula, summation k is equivalent to minus infinity to infinity h of n x of n minus k. Why I am discussing two formulas for each means, for example, you are given with any signal and impulse response. So shifting of signal is easy or impulse response is easy, you need to check. So you can use according to that. That means, for example, in any problem, shifting of x of n is easy and h of n is typical, then you are going to use this formula. For example, in any other problem, shifting of impulse response equation is easy. That means applying shifting for that equation is easy, but it's typical to apply shifting and folding property for signal, then you are going to choose this formula. So according to your feasibility, you need to choose the formula that to calculate convolution of continuous or discrete time system.